Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss derivatives of logarithmic functions. Let's start with an example. Differentiate f of x equals the natural log of x squared plus 3. Solution. But first recall that whenever you have the derivative of the natural log of x, that's going to be equal to 1 over x. So in this particular problem, we have the natural log of x squared plus 3. So we have to use the chain rule. So f prime of x. So you take the derivative of the outside and you leave the inside untouched. So you use this rule. So it's 1 over, but instead of x, we have x squared plus 3. And then you multiply by the derivative of the inside. The derivative of x squared is 2x via the power rule. And the derivative of 3 is 0, so you just get 2x. So again, you take the derivative of the outside using the formula. It's 1 over x squared plus 3, and then times the derivative of the inside, which is 2x. So f prime of x is equal to 2x, all divided by x squared plus 3. And that would be the derivative of the natural log of x squared plus 3. Let's go ahead and do another example. This next example is a little bit different. We have to differentiate y equals x squared times the natural log of x. Solution. So the reason this problem is different is because we have a product. We have x squared times the natural log of x. So whenever you have a product, you can use something called the product rule. It says if you have a function f and you multiply it by a function g and you want the derivative, think of f as your first function and g as your second. It's the derivative of the first times the second plus the first times the derivative of the second. So f prime g plus f g prime. Again, it's much better to think of it in terms of first and second because in the actual problems, as you see here, there's no f and g. But you do have a first function, which is your f, so it's x squared, and your second function, which is your g. So y prime is equal to, so x squared is the first, ln x is the second. It's the derivative of the first times the second plus the first times the derivative of the second. So the derivative of ln x is 1 over x. Let's just check that. So beautiful. The derivative of the first is 2x times the second plus the first, which is x squared, times the derivative of the second. And now we get some cancellation here with the x's. So we end up with y prime equals 2x ln x, and then we lost this x here. It canceled with one of the x's there, so we're left with plus x. And that would be the solution. And again, if that was unclear, it was x squared times 1 over x, and then this is equal to x because the x on the bottom cancels with one of the ones on the top. All right, let's do something a lot more challenging. In this example, we are going to find the derivative using logarithmic differentiation given y equals 2 plus x, all raised to the sine x. Solution. So the first step in this problem is to just write down the question again. So we have y equals parentheses 2 plus x to the sine x. Now we're going to take the natural log of both sides. And the reason we're doing that is because we want to bring down the sine x. So we have ln y equals ln of 2 plus x, and it's all to the sine x power. And now that we have the log here, we can bring down the sine function. So this is the natural log of y equals, and you bring it down, so we get sine x times the natural log of 2 plus x. So the rule we use here was called the power rule. If you have p ln x, it's equal to ln x to the p. Basically, it says that you can take things upstairs or bring them down. So now we'll differentiate both sides with respect to x. Recall that if you have the derivative of ln x, it's 1 over x. However, in this case, we don't have ln x, we have ln y. So y is a function of x. So in this case, we're going to use the chain rule. We take the derivative of the outside, so 1 over y, right, leave the inside untouched, times the derivative of the inside. Well, the derivative of y is simply dy dx. For the right-hand side, we're going to use the power rule. Think of the sine function as your first function and the log function as your second function. So it'll be the derivative of the first, which is cosine, times the second function, which is the natural log of 2 plus x, plus your first function, which is sine x, times the derivative of the natural log of 2 plus x, which is 1 over 2 plus x. Chain rule, derivative of the inside is simply 1 because the derivative of 2 is 0 because it's a constant and the derivative of x is 1. Let's just check that. Derivative of the sine, cosine, times the second, plus the first, which is sine, times the derivative of the natural log of 2 plus x, which is 1 over 2 plus x, times the derivative of the inside, which is 1. Let's multiply both sides by y. So we have dy dx equals y. I'm going to put a bracket here. And then we have cosine x. I'm going to put it in parentheses. Then ln 2 plus x. And then we have plus sine x over 2 plus x. Really crazy looking answers, right? Really fun. And the last step is to maybe replace y with what it is. Recall that y was given at the beginning of the problem. It's the actual question. So let's do that. So dy dx is equal to, well, y was actually 2 plus x to the sine x, then bracket cosine x, ln 2 plus x, and then plus sine x over 2 plus x. And you could distribute and simplify some more, but I will leave it like this. I like it like this. It looks really pretty. Just a really nice answer. And so that's how you use logarithmic differentiation. So just a quick recap. Whenever the question says logarithmic differentiation, the first thing you do is you write down your problem, take the natural log of both sides, okay, and then bring down that exponent. We did that here using the power rule. And then just differentiate. Usually you'll have to use the product rule like we did. And then at the end, just multiply by y. By the way, if it doesn't say use logarithmic differentiation, you might still have to use it. Basically, the idea is you're going to have a variable term, like 2 plus x, to a variable term. So you have variable to a variable. Whenever it's something like that, this is usually a pretty good choice. I hope you've learned some math in this video. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck. And take care.